The campground was here before Susan's dad bought it, but he bought it about 37 years ago.
So when my dad started the campground in 1976, I worked for him as a teenager and grew up. We had our children, and when my dad was ready to retire, then we were able to buy it from them, and our children grew up in this business and worked with us, and now they're moved on, and recently our oldest son has come back.
Mr. D, her dad ran it as a family business, and I got pretty close to the whole family. At the time, we actually didn't date through high school. It was after that we got together. But it seems so natural then because, her dad's a great guy. He taught me an awful lot of stuff.
I know campground owners that are KOAs now that used to not be KOAs. And that was something that they really noticed was a big difference, that they used to be alone in this. And when you're a KOA, you're not alone. So I couldn't imagine doing this as just a private campground without the support of KOA.
If I could tell my fellow owners one, actually would probably be two things that I would mention. Number one would be use the KOA system, use the corporate offices for everything that you can use them for. Use all of your resources. They're there. Don't hesitate to pick up the phone and use them. The other thing would be give new ideas a chance. There are a lot of people that have been running a campground for a lot of years, and you get kind of stuck in your ways, and new ideas come along, and you're not very quick to accept them. And KOA is all about staying on the front of the camping industry. And sometimes you have to be willing to accept things without being sure to yourself that they're exactly right. But give them a chance. At least give them a chance to see whether this is going to work. Don't be so quick to down, because we've been in it a long time, and KOA is always going to have you improve your campground. You can't run a campground by sitting where you are.
You done good goofiness.
Yes.